When we met up, it was disturbing. For the first time, my reflection, she didn't look like me. She was fatter, flushed.
She...
If anything, I was getting skinnier. Found it hard to look, sometimes.
She has multiple personalities.
We talked about what to do. Was it time to become our own people? And that seemed like the right thing to do, but neither of us wanted it. We agreed that her and Simon would get their own place as soon as possible, and then I could move in. And that was the plan.
Oh, we got music playing, because this is significant. Multiple personality disorder, also known as dissociative identity disorder. Identity disorder. Yeah. So we're talking to two different identities. This is Hannah.
My name is Hannah. H-A-N-N-A-H. It's Palindrome. It reads the same backwards as forwards. It doesn't work if you mirror it though. It's not quite symmetrical, but well, I mean, you get the idea. Sorry. Hannah Smith. I live at 31 Gladstone Street.
I'm just watching this again.
The parents decided there would be a wedding. And after the wedding, Hannah moved in with his parents. There was no way I could follow. So we were separated again. I stayed in the attic. It was hard. It's like I suddenly didn't exist. I would sneak out, but in case anyone recognized me, I started wearing a wig. Hannah and I would meet.
Okay. Okay. Either she has an identity disorder, or these are twins. These are two different people. I'm going for identity disorder. It's kind of weird though. I'm thinking back to that one in the bar where she was talking about she's singing and he says that she looked just like, he couldn't, like there was a striking resemblance and all this. Obviously, I don't know who's talking, Hannah or the other one, but he knows the other one and said she looked like that one. But obviously she's different enough so that he didn't think, well, it's her. No, it's someone who looks just like her. And it's so freaking weird. Okay. I'm trying to figure out. Twin dissociative identity disorder. She looks a little tired or upset right here. You okay over there?
What are you doing talking about Eve?
Eve. Here's the mirror. Who's Eve? Interesting. Very interesting. Ooh. She wasn't being interviewed at that time. She was just in the room. She was waiting, and then the, you know, investigator, whatever we would like to call this person who's interviewing her, came in the room at that moment. So Eve, I wrote down with a question mark. Let's see what other Hannah stuff we have. Very interesting now.
Yes. My name is Hannah Smith.
Oh, she's under a lie detector test.
Shit. Sorry.
What do you mean, sorry? Your name's not Hannah Smith? 11-27-01. Probably missing something in between, but here's the next one out of them.
Across the road, where my parents first lived there, was a midwife called Florence. When Hannah was born, I was born at the same time.
Okay.
The midwife was there to help.
Twins?
I'd been throttled by the cord, probably wrapped around my neck by Hannah. The midwife told my mother I was dead. But I wasn't. She wrote all this stuff in a diary. Amazing what people will admit to on paper.
Oh, we're fading here. I saw that. So if she's telling the truth, that makes sense, because she said she doesn't exist. Back when she was talking about, you know, singing in clubs and stuff, she didn't exist. So wait. I gotta watch this again.
Across the road, where my parents first lived there, when Hannah was born, I was born at the same time. The midwife was there to help. I'd been throttled by the cord, probably wrapped around my neck by Hannah. The midwife told my mother I was dead. But I wasn't. She wrote all this stuff in a diary. Amazing what people will admit to on paper.
So Hannah, if this is all true, by the way, if she has dissociative identity disorder, there is only one of her. So really talking to one person with, you know, multiple personalities, a split personality, or we are talking actually to two different people. How to tell them apart, right? How do we tell them apart then? Other than what they're seeing at that time. If they're talking about the other one, then obviously that one. But Hannah is, saying this whole twin thing is true, Hannah is the one that exists. Hannah is the one with the identity, the documents, and everything. Whoever this is, if this is Eve or somebody else, she doesn't exist, but she plays the part of Hannah. She can use her identity, and everything else. Yeah. So I wonder if Simon, or whoever she was talking about at the bar, realized, I'm still going by the assumption twin here, realized that that's her twin. And wow, you just look just like her and all this stuff, and they go on a date and stuff. So in that case, one of the twins probably killed Simon, I'm thinking. If it is dissociative identity disorder, obviously only she would have killed Simon, most probably, so far, going from the evidence. She really didn't mention anybody else prominently. so, unless it's something we have yet to see. So, that's what I'm thinking. And of course, then she'll get off, you know, an insanity plea. So we've got one more here.
She recognized me from the window.
Who?
She told me to come inside, and she hid me. They had made the attic into a place where Hannah could play. It was a dollhouse. She hid me up there. No one else ever went into the attic. It was her place.
So is she talking about her twin? I keep thinking something's going to happen, but we can't leave this screen. If I exit out here, that ends the game, at least for now. I'm going to search for a few other things. I'm going to eliminate some things. I want anything else about this store, this song. Come back and stay, right? No. Not with quotes or inverted commas, whatever the hell they said. Just that one. Okay. We can eliminate that. She was talking about Oxford way back in the beginning, and I haven't looked that up yet. There's two more about Oxford. This is really short.
There was a conference. Something to do with double glazing. In Oxford?
Okay. Same session here. That's the same tattoo, right?
It was supposed to be a secret. Just because Simon is dead doesn't mean I have to give up all his secrets. It doesn't have anything to do with what happened to Simon. No one murdered my husband because he cheated his expenses for a romantic weekend in Oxford.
Well, it looks like he cheated with her twin. I mean, we don't know if it went any further than that. He asked her, right, the twin, the not Hannah, to kiss him. And, well, we don't know if she did or not. Of course, I can look up kiss, right? Look at that. So, okay, so that's the one where she said, I should skip around with this one.
Nothing else happened that night. We talked again, and there he was. Next week, my meal. I'd eaten, so we got chips and ate them on the beach instead. Goodbye. He asked me to kiss him. Romantic.
So that's that. And this is all the same session. 11:55, 16:53. Let's play this one first. So it's this one, and then the scene on the beach when he asked her to kiss him. This one first.
Hannah was so smitten with Simon. She started getting jealous. Didn't want to share.
Wait, this is not Hannah.
Even the first date. We went to see Tom Cruise at the Old Odeon. We both went. Kept changing places in the toilet. We only had one best dress, so we had to keep swapping clothes. Must have thought we had terrible bladder problems. Huh. The next date, it was my turn. At the end, I let him kiss me. But that was it.
They took
turns.
We
didn't want to have Carl in the hands, and the Ouija board had said to hold back.
It was Carl? Ouija board?
After that, it was Hannah's turn, and she slept with him. Broke the rules. Deliberately broke the rules. She wanted to be the first to sleep with him.
Huh.
I mean, that's when she got pregnant. From that one time.
And she struggled and struggled to get pregnant. And Hannah got pregnant that... Of course we can eliminate the white shirt. I'm gonna make another note here. White shirt is not Hannah. Which might be Eve. Which I have to look up as well. Alright, let's... So then we have this one, 11:55 and 16. Immediately, looks like 16 plus 32 is 44? No, 48, sorry. So I got a few seconds missing, but this is like pretty much right after. The beach scene here on in.
Yes. I thought about telling Hannah. I felt guilty after the kiss.
She did kiss him.
But then it began to feel like this was the way it should be. Sharing. Like we had before. He never mentioned her to me. There was the silence with me and the silence with her. It was almost like it was a different silence.
Huh?
But
it wasn't. Imagine if he had a twin as well. That would be too funny. And this is 11:55:53, 36 seconds. So that's 11:56:29 is the next. So this is 5 seconds gap in between. But this is probably next.
After the kiss, the next time, he took me back to the house, to our parents' house, to their house. So, it was definitely him. I sometimes think he wanted to get caught to prove to himself that we were different people. He told me about his marriage, told me how his wife was completely different to me. I almost burst out laughing.
What I really want to do is see if they both have the same exact tattoo. That would mean they're the same person. And not twins. So this is not Hannah. Sorry.
My name is Hannah. H-A-N-N-A-H. It's Poundre.
Okay. So the blue... with the tank top... the blue blouse with the tank top is Hannah. Just trying to figure out the Hannahs and not Hannah. And this one was between interviews, right? I think that's Hannah talking to herself, but I'm going to put a question mark. Splotchy blue and white button shirt, isn't it? Button shirt equals Hannah question mark. That's the only one we've seen with that shirt so far. So this one, she got a lie detector test. What are the results of the test?
Yes. My name is Hannah Smith. Oh, shit. Sorry.
isn't that the same as here? Did she get a zap or something? No, it's not. It doesn't zap her. But why'd she say, oh, sorry? March 7th. Of course they could be screwing us up and, you know, switching outfits. They both could be wearing the white. Right? Hannah one day. Eve, I'm guessing, the next. March, or 7-3, right? 7-3.
She recognized me from the window. Inside, made the house, bring up the house at her place.
That is kind of weird. It's like she was saying she was one person, then she said sorry. Because I have the white shirt as being not Hannah. Maybe she's just making up a complete story. Like she said in the beginning, we've all been telling these stories to each other. But they're not necessarily true. That's one of the first ones we watched. It's a longish one. Wait. This actually stuck down in here. 17 seconds. I don't know. Oh, I moved them around, didn't I? Crap, I don't even know now. It was longer. It was like almost a minute, wasn't it? That's the one, okay. That's me. Let me just play this one really quick.
I didn't murder Simon. You've got it wrong. You've got the wrong person. I'd like to speak to a lawyer now. Please. You have no murder weapon. You have nothing. And all these stories we've been telling each other?
Yes.
Just that. Stories.
I thought it was longer. This is the one I was looking for. That's July. That's like after a lot of the stuff we've been watching. Alright. I am going to look for Eve. I just want to... Anything else that talks about a river? Is this one? Now this, I'm not sure who this is. Unless it's that one with the tank top. This is the tank top under there. 618. No. I mean, it could be. I mean, no, this is... That's lower cut, definitely. God knows that. So I don't know who this is.
Okay. You got me. I'll confess. We were there.
Down by the river.
It was a dirty weekend. Simon was going to expense it. Pretend it was a business trip. I used a made-up name. We stayed at the hotel. Had room service, didn't leave the room, had a great view of the river, and you could hear the church bells. Like you said, it was very romantic. Mm.
The interviewer said it was romantic. Now I wonder if both of them have a tattoo. Wait. Thank you. I thought the white shirt was not Hannah. I'm so confused here, guys.
So I moved out. In a box to cover my rent.
She doesn't exist.
He saw me singing. I had a drink at the bar and he came over. I knew who he was, but he didn't know who I was. He was fascinated by the likeness. He guessed my name from my tattoo. Told me it was a palindrome, but that would impress me.
Oh, that doesn't say, because Eve is also... Okay, I gotta look up freaking Eve already. Eve and Hannah are both palindromes, so you can't go by that. But Eve apparently has a tattoo that says Eve. And Hannah... Hold on. I wish I could open multiple windows here. River? I'm going back to this. Okay, so then the blue T is Hannah. Hannah is the one with the actual identity.
Okay, you got me. I'll confess. Pretend it was a business trip. View of the river. It was very romantic.
So that's the business trip to Oxford, I think? Right. So I just want to look up... Crap. I do have to look up church. I'm going to look up Eve. That's mentioning Eve. We've seen that. Oh, it's just barely underneath where you can see. Let me see if you can see the tattoo here. Not really, right? Can't see any tattoo of any kind there.
Well, my friend Eve. She was a friend from when I was a kid. And she was always more popular with the boys, and I used to hate her for it.
Okay.
Really hate her sometimes.
Not the twin? She had a friend called Eve. This is back on... June 30th. So kind of near the end of the footage we've been seeing so far.
Yes. We'd fight. We fought on the beach once and I held Eve's head underwater.
Oh, nice.
There was no one else around. It was at the far end of the beach. And I held her head under and I kept it up.
Murder.
And for a moment, I just wanted to kill her and watch her drown. But that was it. It was just a moment. We made up afterwards. It was a love-hate relationship.
So if that is Eve, Eve's the one who's telling all. It looks like Eve is telling this whole story, which may or may not be true. And if that's Hannah, she's not bringing up the whole thing. Just, she's a friend. She's holding back.
Yeah.
Unless it isn't true. So, wait. Hope you guys enjoy stumbling around trying to figure this crap out. So these are all the same day, obviously. 1550. 1551. 1552. 1553. So this is all in order. We've got this short one.
Well, my friends, really hate it sometimes.
Right, so then she talking about drowning under the water, and this one is next, at least out of this footage here.
A police station. Yeah. When I was young, we ran away on my birthday. Bob Dylan was playing in London, and we thought we could break into his tour bus and have him take us with him.
Into Dylan's tour bus?
A taxi driver we paid to drop us off. I mean, we'd save money, pinched a bit here and there to pay for the fare. He was suspicious because we were so young, so he told the police. So they came and picked us up and took me back to Portsmouth. My mum picked me up in the station. But I blamed everything on my friend Eve. So my parents let me off.
Huh. She blamed everything on her friend Eve. So she's going on about this, and then she has this moment where she's like, oh, why would we talk about Eve? Why'd you mention Eve?
What are you doing talking about Eve?
And then she does that weird drumming thing with her fingers. So this... Alright. So I'm thinking Eve is the other twin, or other personality. So the splotchy blue-white, this is Hannah. I'm going to take the question mark away from that. This is Eve.
My mother called me Eve.
Okay. So that's pretty much established, unless there's some real twist here. So I want to go back to the church. There's bound to be a few more in the church. Oh, we only have one missing. So who's this then? She's drawing a map.
Yes. I drove in here because I remember, well, I
went 27th.
And then there was a church. There. Yeah. And I probably parked. Well, I remember seeing a street sign called... There.
Okay, I don't know which one that is. This is... Hannah. Talking about the church.
No.
A church.
I was 15. Carl was older. 17, I think.
It's another one I have to look at.
I was really into him, regardless of how he actually behaved.
Huh.
Lots of drunken teenage sex. We did it in a church once. It's stupid. So he got tired of us and we split up after about 6 months.
Of us, both of them?
What's sad. Those early experiences, they help you realise who's really important to you, you know? Family.
So that's this agreement she has with her twin sister.